Mushrooms. First and foremost, what is a mushroom? Mushrooms are a kind of fungus that grow above ground or on their food source. When people hear the word mushroom, they usually think of the kind that looks like this. These mushrooms have three primary parts: the stem, cap, and gills. The gills are what hold the mushroom's spores, which are similar to the seeds of plants. While this is the common idea of a mushroom, mushroom can actually mean a great many things. It could be an umbrella term for most fungus, or it can mean Ascomycota, which look more like weird fruit than a mushroom. Basically, mushroom can mean a multitude of things just depending on the context you use. One of the most infamous aspects of mushrooms is how fast they grow. In just one night, they can go from cute little toadstools to gross, fleshy dinner plates. The interesting thing about this so-called growth is that they aren't growing the way you probably think they are. Mushrooms seem to pop up overnight and then grow like there's no tomorrow, but in reality, they spend quite a while growing underground before popping above ground. Once they're above ground, cells that were created during their early life rapidly expand once they come in contact with moisture. Now that you know a little bit about mushrooms in general, here's a closer look at a couple cool types of mushrooms. The death cap. The death cap is the deadliest mushroom. It is responsible for the most fatal mushroom poisonings of any mushroom. The death cap appears to be just a regular mushroom. At its biggest, its cap is 6 inches wide and stem 5 inches tall. It's a beige-brownish color, feels a little sticky, but it smells terrible. The stink of the death cap has a purpose though. The stink attracts bugs that get stuck to the mushroom, covered in spores, and then fly away to distribute the spores. Eating a death cap almost ensures death. Symptoms don't start until 10 or 14 hours after consumption, but they're fairly mild. After a brief bout of nausea or sickness, people usually feel better, but within the next few days, the poison in the death caps causes kidney or liver failure. Many people mistake the death cap for harmless types of mushrooms, so never, 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 never eat mushrooms in the wild. Ever. Shrooms. Hallucinogenic mushrooms. There are quite a few of these mushrooms, but we're going to focus on the fly agaric, probably the most well-known mushroom of all time. Its bright red color and white spots make it the storybook mushroom that everyone knows about, but it does much more than look cute and decorate enchanted forests. This mushroom is sacred to many religions and has been used for 6,000 years. It causes a kind of psychedelic frenzy that gives a person superhuman strength, alters their perception of time, and makes everything around them extremely too big or extremely too small. If you've ever read or watched Alice in Wonderland, you probably remember the high caterpillar who was probably eating some of the mushroom he was sitting on. You may also remember the bottles and foods labeled Eat Me and Drink Me that Alice uses to change size. These may be references to the effects of shrooms. The fly agaric is also often associated with garden gnomes because people often claim to see mushroom men after eating them. Looking at history, there are stories about shamans that took the mushrooms and then met short necklace men that would lead them to the other world. Shamans made sure to only take 2.5 mushrooms though, because it would cause 2.5 mushroom men to appear, and the shaman could only keep up with the half man as they ran down the path to the other world. This kind of mushroom isn't addictive, but it never became too popular as a mainstream drug because it makes you throw up and comes with a pretty nasty hangover. So now you can go outside and look at those mushrooms in your front yard with your new knowledge. Just don't eat them. Please don't eat them.